Alright guys, Ivan here with another video, and in this video I'm gonna show you the footage from Indy Pro that I found right now. And from what I can see, Steve Cuclo is winning it. Steve Cuclo is probably winning it. He really brought an amazing package, and overall this show is looking great. Basically, Luke is in his regular shape. He's not looking worse or better, but maybe he does look a little bit worse. He's kind of looking a little bit dry. And I'm curious, why is he not in this lineup right now next to Steve? Maybe something happened, maybe he got sick or something like that. I hope that's not the case, but Steve brought it. Steve brought an amazing conditioning with amazing fullness and great lines. You guys know I'm not the biggest fan of Steve, because he doesn't have the deep separation, the dryness, the details, you know, the pop, the 3D look. But you cannot dismiss his shape and his... I would say perfection. He doesn't have that many flaws, you know. He has the back, he has the arms, he has the chest, everything, every single muscle is on point, you know. The thing is, he doesn't have the best conditioning every time. And even when he does, he has that paper thin skin with the crazy vascularity, but he doesn't show the deepest separation of the muscle. But this time, he really brought some amazing package. Here is Hassan Mostafa, and he's not looking that impressive that I expected, to be honest. So look at Steve now, and look at this free posing routine. So he's definitely dry. Look at the separation and the details and the hardness of his physique. Everything is on point, so I'm thinking he's gonna take it. Probably, most likely. He is the last year winner, so he has an advantage from that standpoint. Although Luke has placed third at the Iron Classic Ohio, which is second most prestigious competition in bodybuilding, so he has an advantage probably over Steve, but I think Steve brought much improved package from before, and I think he's bigger than Luke. I mean, both of these guys are very big, but when they both bring conditioning, it's probably gonna be Steve who is bigger. So yeah, he looks fuller, and for that reason, look at the back, and for that reason he's gonna win it probably. I like his lines more than those of Luke Sandoe, but Luke has harder look a little bit. But right now I wouldn't say so. So look at Luke now, and the first thing that pops to my eyes is his legs. Steve has better legs, and the tightness in the shoulder area. Luke is kind of tight upstairs, and Steve is much wider upstairs. And yeah, the chest of Luke is also kind of looking flat. I don't think this is the best Luke we ever saw. His best was at Iron Classic Ohio, but he was worse at the Australia. Now he's even worse than Australia, I think. I mean, he's shredded, don't get me wrong. He's peeled, he's ready. But the fullness is, I don't know, it disappeared a little bit. Why is that? I have no idea. You can ask him. And his back, oh, doesn't look proportional at all in this back double bicep. I don't know why he's doing it like that, but it just doesn't look good. So yeah, I'm thinking he's gonna be second place. Akim Williams, you know, very impressive guy, but he's too short and his legs don't look very good. From the back though, from the back he looks like Ronnie Coleman, a little Ronnie Coleman. And he's probably gonna take fourth place. Third place is gonna be probably, okay, let's look at the back first. So yeah, very good back. Glutes are very, very hard. He's the probably the strongest bodybuilder of today. He's a very strong guy. But doesn't matter, you know, who cares about that. And here you can see Justin Rodriguez. His stomach is not his best body part, but he actually brought an amazing conditioning, especially from the back. Look at the glutes, look at the back. He's gonna be maybe even second. Maybe he's gonna beat Luke. But actually, I will say so. He's gonna beat Luke. We'll see. It's too bold to say something like that, but he looks great. And this Hassan Mostafa guy... it's not the best video that you can see here, but it is what it is. And you can see that he has amazing legs, big legs, huge legs, but the conditioning is not on point. So he may end up fifth or even worse than that. I have no idea, but he's not looking as impressive as I expected him to be. But he's a prospect. He's gonna bring something better probably in the near future. So this is only a start. This is his pro debut. What else can you expect from a guy that is doing his first pro show ever? He's not feel heat to win it or something like that. But he definitely looks amazing for a rookie. And yeah, you can see from the back, he's looking better because his glutes and his legs are really overpowering. And his back is good, but his chest is kind of too tight, too narrow, so it doesn't look, you know, the best. And that's about it for this video, guys. Tell me what you think, who's gonna win it, and if you enjoyed the video, make sure to like the video. If you want to see more bodybuilding coverage like this, subscribe to my channel. All the best, guys. Bye-bye.